Rip the clappers and try.
The group D strapter or another one, because group D strapter is like a different strapter, right? And we didn't classify as group D. It's enterococcus, right? So enterococcus fecalis. Are you recording? It's enterococcus fecalis, right? So what is the reaction happening here? So there is this bioesculin test, right? So what were you, you're checking the esculin, right? What's happening with the esculin?
It's reacting with ferric citrate.
Yeah, so the esculin that is reacting, what is reacting with the ferric acid?
Esculatin.
Esculatin. So the bacteria enterococcus, it's breaking the esculin, right? And then it's breaking esculin into esculatin and glucose, right? So the esculatin, the broken esculatin is going to be reacting with what?
Ferric citrate.
The ferric citrate. And then this is going to be turning the color to dark color. Okay? So that's a reaction. And why is the name of the test called the bioesculin test? Where's the bio? What is the function of the bio? Is inhibit the growth of other bacteria, right? Not a lot of bacteria can tolerate the bio. Enterococcus is one of the bacteria that can tolerate the bio, right? And also can break the esculin, okay? So that's why we usually, if you want to identify enterococcus fecalis, if we suspect that we have enterococcus fecalis, we use the bioesculin